Hello, everyone. Good morning. Pastor Dennis here.
大家早上好，欢迎大家再次的出席。
And we are so excited that we can be together on this Hope Coaching online service.
我们很高兴欢迎能够大家再次的出席我们今天早上的这个线上主日。
I hope you're doing well.
我希望大家都是安好的。
It has been a very long, many weeks of MCO.
我们已经过了许多个这个行动管制令的星期了。
And maybe by now we have adjusted to staying at home much better than in the early weeks.
那或许现在的你在家里已经开始了习惯。
However it is, I really pray that you will experience God's goodness all the time.
无论如何，我都希望你都一直经历上帝的美好。
Last week, we talked about how God is generous to give everyone eternal life.
上个星期我们提及关于上帝的慷慨，并为每个人提供了永生。
And whoever responds to work in his vineyard basically have entered into that life.
那些真的是在回应上帝在他的葡萄园里面做工的，基本上都已经进入了这个永生的生命。
Just as God is generous to us, God desires us to be generous in our life as well.
就如同上帝如何的慷慨对待于我们每一个人，他也期望我们每一个人也能够慷慨的对待每一个其他的人。
And so this is a very important topic, especially in this time of MCO.
那因此呢，在这个行动管制令的期间，这个是一个很有趣的课题。
There have been records or reports about people who don't have enough to eat, and people who are homeless, people who can hardly survive because of the MCO.
我们也看到了许多的这个报道，关于到这些贫穷的人，这些困苦，完全没有食物好吃的人，在这个行动管制令期间，他们或许都无家可归。
The question is, we can be generous in good times, but can we be generous in difficult times?
那问题是，我们能够在好日子的时候过着一个慷慨的生活，那我们是否能够在比较困苦的时候过着一个慷慨的生活呢？
So today we talk about this topic of generosity and gold.
那因此，今天我们要提到关于到慷慨以及黄金这个课题。
In particular, your generosity and my generosity, your goal and my goal.
特别是指向你和我的慷慨，你和我的黄金。
Now, gold is not just about money.
那这个黄金提到的不只关于到金钱，
Gold is about anything that is precious to us.
它可以是任何对我们很宝贵的事物。
Whatever that enable us to make money, that's gold.
任何能够使我们赚取金钱的，也都是这个黄金。
Could be our time, our knowledge, our experience, our skills.
它可以是我们的时间、我们的知识、我们的精力、我们的技能。
All these things we use to make gold.
这些让我们能够去制造黄金的事物。
So I'm not just talking about money.
所以我不只单单提到金钱罢了。
In the next half an hour, I want to encourage us to think how we can use the gold in our lives to be generous in the time of MCO.
那接下来这个时段，我需要大家一起跟我思考，我们要如何的使用我们的黄金，在这一段行动管制令的期间去祝福别人。
And to do that, we want to look at the life of Jesus Christ.
那我们如果要因这样子做的话，我们需要看耶稣的生命。
We want to see how Jesus looks at life, how he looks at money, how he looks at people.
我们要看一下耶稣是如何的看待生命、黄金以及他的百姓。
I'm going to read from Luke chapter 20, verse 23 to 25.
那我们要看今天的经文是取自于路加福音20章23到25节。
Someone asked Jesus the question, "Is it right for us to pay taxes to Caesar or not?" And Jesus said to them, "Show me a denarius, that's a silver coin, whose image and inscription are on it." "Caesar's," they replied. And so Jesus said to them, "Then give back to Caesar what is Caesar's, and to God what is God's."
我们纳税给该杀，可以不可以？耶稣就对他们说：“拿一个银钱来给我看，这像和这号是谁的？”他们说是该杀的。耶稣说：“这样，该杀的物当归给该杀，神的物当归给神。”
Let us pray.
让我们来祷告。
Heavenly Father, we thank you for you are a generous God to us.
我们天上的父，我们感谢你，因着你是一个慷慨的上帝。
You have given Jesus Christ to be our Lord and Savior.
你赐了耶稣成为我们的主和救主。
And today, through his finished work at the cross and resurrection, and trusting you, we have become the children of God.
那今天呢，透过他在十字架所成就的救赎和复活，让我们能够成为你的儿女。
We pray for everybody, who might be going through some challenges and difficulties in their lives today.
我们为着那些现在正在经历这一些生命困苦的人来代祷。
Please speak to us through your word.
透过你的话语来跟我们说话。
Regarding generosity and gold.
关于慷慨与黄金。
In Jesus' name we pray.
用耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So there are three things that I want to talk about this morning.
所以今天早上我跟大家分享关于三样的事物。
First of all, something to avoid.
第一方面我们要避免什么呢？
Secondly, something that we need to get.
那第二方面我们要获得什么呢？
And thirdly, something for us to recognize.
那第三方面我们要认得什么呢？
With all these three, we can understand better about how to be generous with our goal.
那透过这三样事情，我们能够学习如何的更加的慷慨，特别是对于我们的黄金。
So, to be generous with our goal, the first thing we must do is to avoid the trap.
那第一样事物呢，就是我们要避免陷阱。
Avoid making a mistake.
我们要避免促成一些的错误。
You see, the people asked Jesus a very powerful question, which is actually a trap.
那其实你看到百姓问耶稣这个问题的时候，其实是一种陷阱。
They asked Jesus, is it right for the Jewish people to pay taxes to the Roman conquerors?
所以他们就问说，是否是正确的？他们真的是把他们的钱缴税给这个罗马的兵士呢？
And the question was asked because they want to trap Jesus.
他们问了这个问题是为了要制造一个陷阱给耶稣。
Is it right to pay taxes to Caesar or not?
所以我们还税给该杀是对的吗？
Either Jesus will answer yes or no.
所以答案呢，应该是是或者不是。
We need to learn to avoid the trap of either or.
我们一定要学习如何的避免两者任意的陷阱。
And Jesus teaches us how to answer such a sensitive question.
所以耶稣在这里就教导我们如何的去回应这种敏感的问题。
For Jesus, it was a very difficult question.
对于耶稣来说，这是很困难的一个问题。
Because this question of paying taxes have caused riots and demonstrations among the Jewish people at that time.
因为这个问题呢，在当时引起了犹太人对罗马人的示威和暴动。
People who rebel and refuse to pay are arrested and executed.
那些不愿意缴税的人呢，他们就会被抓起来。
And the people, especially the poor, feel the heaviness of this tax.
那些贫穷的人，他们就会觉得非常的沉重。
So Jesus' answer will definitely make someone happy and someone very unhappy.
因此耶稣的答案有可能会让一些的人很开心，另外一般的人却很不开心。
If he answers yes or no.
无论他是回答是或者不是。
So, what did Jesus do to avoid the trap?
那耶稣做了什么为了避免这个陷阱呢？
If Jesus said, no, you should not pay the taxes.
那如果耶稣说不，你不应该缴税的话，
the Jewish people will be very happy.
那么犹太人就会很高兴。
In fact, they are looking for someone who would lead them to rebel against the Romans.
其实他们也在寻找一个能够帮助他们来叛逆与这个罗马的人。
But if Jesus said no to taxes, immediately the Romans will arrest him and he will be executed.
那但是耶稣如果回答不应该缴这个税的话，那他就会是被视为一个叛逆者，并且会被处死。
But if Jesus says, yes, you must pay the tax to the Romans.
但是如果耶稣回答是，你应当缴这个税给罗马人。
then the Jewish people will be very angry with him and they will hate him.
那这个犹太人他就会很生气，也会很憎恨耶稣了。
Jesus will lose his credibility as a teacher.
那耶稣就会失去了他身为一个老师的这个样式。
So the question is yes or no.
所以那个问题就是是或者不是的。
Which one would Jesus answer?
那耶稣应该怎么回答呢？
We face a similar issue today in our lives.
那今天在我们的生活里面也面临的类似的问题。
For example, is it right for us to help people or not when we ourselves might not have enough?
那比如说当我们自己都不足够的时候，那我们是否还应该帮助其他的人呢？
Can we still be generous with our goal?
我们还能够很慷慨吗？
Every day we read of people who are going hungry without food, even in Malaysia.
那甚至在马来西亚，每天我们都会看到不同的报道，告诉我们说还有这些贫穷困苦的人。
Maybe you see people who are in need around you where you stay.
或者你在你的住宅区的周围，你都看到有这一些有需要的人。
Do we close our eyes from seeing this?
我们是否是闭上眼睛而不观看呢？
Give or not give?
给或不给？
Volunteer to help or not volunteer?
我们要自愿来帮忙或者不自愿呢？
And for example, the blood bank in Kuching is running low and they're asking for blood donation. So the question is, donate or not donate?
就比如说我们的血库现在其实是不够血的，那个问题就是我们是否应当捐或者不捐血呢？
What will you do?
你会怎么做？
Is there something for us that we can do?
我们是否还有能够做的事情呢？
To be generous with our goal.
好让我们对于我们的黄金是慷慨的。
Last week, my wife and I helped a family that was about to be kicked out of the place where they stay.
那上个星期呢，我的妻子和我本身就帮助了另一个因为无法支付房租而差点无家可归的家庭了。
Because of the MCO, they were not able to make enough money to pay for the rent.
因着他们在这个行动管制令的一个期间，他们并没有足够的能够赚取金钱来付他们的房租。
And you know, we cannot help everybody, but we can help somebody.
那我们当然不能帮助所有的人，但是我们所有的人都能够帮助某一些人。
The important thing is the people that got put a burden in our heart, let us be the one to help them.
重点是当上帝把一些的人成为我们生命里面的负担，让我们能够伸手去帮助这些人。
So for the next 30 seconds, could you make use of the Facebook and put in comments about how you have blessed someone in need over the last few weeks without giving specific names, but I know it's going to be a great encouragement to all of us.
那好不好，接下来的30秒里面，你在这个面子书的评论那里，你就写下你过去的几个星期在这个行动管制令的期间，你如何的帮助到另外一个人。那你不需要提及他们的具体的姓名，那我相信你所写的这些能够鼓励到我们这里的每一个人。
Could you quickly write in your comments now? Thank you.
那这个时候你就鼓励你快点的写下你的评语，谢谢你。
And if you cannot do it right now, maybe throughout this message, you can add on your story about how you have blessed someone.
如果你现在来不及写的话，那你接下来的时间你还可以继续的写下来。
Thank you very much.
谢谢你们。
We love to look forward to reading your comments and testimonies.
我们很期待看到你的见证。
So, like Jesus, we must learn to avoid the trap.
那就像耶稣一样，我们需要避免这个陷阱。
And to avoid the trap, actually, we all need a second thing, and that is we need to get God's wisdom.
如果我们要避免这个陷阱的话，那我们需要第二样的事情，就是获得上帝的智慧。
God's wisdom is powerful, and God's wisdom is what you and I need in our life today.
上帝的智慧是大有能力，也是你和我今天所需要的事物。
And we need God's wisdom, just like Jesus have the wisdom of God.
We need
God's wisdom to help us balance our understanding between generosity and goal.
我们需要上帝的智慧来帮助我们平衡慷慨和金。
And so for Jesus, in that situation, that difficult situation, he had to decide, is it yes or no, or is there another answer?
所以就在那个很辛苦的一个环境里面, 耶稣就需要, 有这个智慧来做一个回答, 是或者不是, 或者是还有另外一个答案呢?
And God gave Jesus the wisdom to look at the obvious facts.
那上帝这个时候就给耶稣, 这个智慧来观看那明显的事实。
When you and I face difficult situations, be open to hear from God.
当你和我面对一些的困难的时候, 让我们能够敞开自己本身来聆听上帝要跟我们说的。
Jesus did not feel pressured to answer emotionally.
耶稣并没有感到很压力, 导致于他需要用, 情感来回应。
He was not going to answer based on rumors or popular opinions.
他也不是按着谣言或者猜测来回应。
He was not going to answer in order to make the Romans happy or to make the people happy.
他也没有, 因为要使那个罗马, 百姓, 开心或者使那个犹太人开心, 做出他的答案。
He want to always speak the truth.
他只要永远说出真相。
And so let's look at what Jesus did.
那我们一起来看耶稣做了什么事情。
Jesus asked for a coin.
所以耶稣这个时候就, 要求一个银钱。
Not just any coin, but he asked for a denarius.
不是任何的银钱, 就是他们当时用的那个一钱银子的钱。
The denarius is a silver coin.
所以他所要的这个硬币是一个银钱。
And it is the coin that the Jewish people had to use in order to pay the Roman taxes.
所以他使用的这个银钱呢, 就是犹太人使用来 缴税的那个硬币。
And Jesus said, whose face is on the coin?
所以耶稣就说, 在这个银钱上是有谁的头像呢?
Whose name is on the coin?
还有谁的, 名字是刻在这个银上呢?
And the people answered, Caesar's face and Caesar's name.
所以百姓就回应说, 是该撒的脸和该撒的名字。
See, that was the obvious fact.
所以那个是很明显的事实。
And from that fact, Jesus revealed the wisdom of God.
所以就从这个事实, 耶稣彰显了上帝的智慧。
And this wisdom is a principle for the way you and I are to live our lives today.
所以这个智慧呢, 就是你和我今天应当使用的来过着我们的生活。
So Jesus said, give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and give to God what belongs to God.
所以耶稣就回答说, 那属于该撒的就归给该撒, 属于上帝的就归给上帝。
Likewise, in this time of MCO, we can apply this principle for our lives.
那相同的, 在这段行动管制令的期间, 我们可以这样子的去应用这个原则。
For example, we should give to the government what belongs to the government.
比如说我们应该给予我们的政府什么是属于政府的。
We should obey the MCO.
我们应该遵守行动管制令。
We should stay at home.
我们应该待在家里。
And avoid going out unnecessarily.
也, 不要外出, 如果没有需要的话。
We should practice proper hygiene and social distancing.
我们应该要保持我们的, 整洁。
And if you are going out, remember that you can only go out one person in a car and you must wear your mask.
那如果你要出去的话, 那你记得只可以一个人在一辆车里, 并且要戴上你的口罩。
And if you have to go to the hospital, you're called to go for the testing for COVID.
那如果你需要去医院, 然后要, 查验你的这个新冠肺炎的话,
cooperate with the doctors and nurses.
让我们能够跟医生和护士配合。
Don't hide anything.
不要隐瞒任何的事实。
Be polite, be kind, be helpful.
我们可以有礼貌, 很友善。
So that's give to, this how we give to Caesar.
所以这个就是我们如何的给予该撒。
At this time as well, we might hear a lot of appeals for donations from all kinds of people.
那同样在这个期间呢, 我们会听到有很多, 需要人家捐赠的这个机构。
We should be very careful not to fall for for scams.
我们要特别的注意，我们没有跌入了这个欺诈的这个手段的网络。
We want to help, but we don't want to be cheated.
我们要帮助，但是我们不要受骗。
So you must look for the facts.
所以我们要查验这个事实。
Check out the organization thoroughly before you decide to donate.
我们要核实过这个机构之后呢，我们才给。
And we should also give to our boss what belongs to our boss.
那同样的，我们应该给予我们的老板那些属于我们老板的。
Give to our company what belongs to our company.
给予我们的公司属于我们公司的。
For those of us who are working in the essential service, it is like every normal day at work.
给予那些真的是在必需品的这个场合做工的，那你们的生活应该还是跟平常一样。
But for many of us who are working at home, we must do an honest day's job at home.
但是给予那些从家里工作的人，那我们意味着我们还是要做一个诚实的员工。
So this is how we give to our boss what belongs to our boss.
所以这个就是我们能够把属于老板的给回我们的老板。
Now, many people say before the MCO that they are too busy, they have no time for God.
那很多人或许在行动管制令之前呢，都说他们没有时间给予上帝。
But now that we are in MCO, we have more time. We have no excuse.
但是在现在的这个期间，我相信大家都有更多的时间了。
God wants us to be generous in giving Him our time and attention.
那上帝同样的也期待他的百姓能够给予属于他的这个时间。
Because our God is a heavenly Father, and He wants to relate with each one of us.
因为我们的天父，他要跟我们每一个人都有联系。
Give to God what belongs to God.
所以给回神属于神的。
Give Him time in prayer, in the Word, in worship.
所以在我们的敬拜、我们的读经、我们的祷告上，都给回上帝属于他的时间。
And while we are at home, we also need to give to our spouse what belongs to our spouse, and we should give to our children what belongs to our children.
同样的，我们在家中的这个期间呢，我们应该给我们的配偶属于我们的配偶的，给我们的孩子属于我们的孩子的。
We should give our family our time, our love, our attention, our care.
所以应该给予我们的家人这个时间、这个注重，还有这个关怀。
It is a time to build good relationships.
它是一个时机，让我们能够建立那美好的关系。
So you can see that this principle applies not just to Caesar, it applies to every area of our lives.
所以你可以看到这个原则，它不只是能够应用在该杀那里，也可以应用在每一个人的生命里面。
And we also should give to our parents what belongs to our parents.
我们也应该给予我们的父母亲所属于他们的。
And especially if they are staying with us at this time.
特别是如果他这个时候是跟我们居住在一起。
So give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, give to God what belongs to God.
给予该杀属于该杀的，给予上帝属于上帝。
Let us also look at the facts of how we use our money.
让我们也看一下我们如何的花钱。
We should be very wise in how we use money.
我们应该很有智慧如何的去使用我们的金钱。
Maybe it's a time for us to spend less on expensive things so that we have money which can be used to bless the needy.
或许这个时候我们应该少可以节省下来，然后使用我们的省下来的金钱呢，去帮助那些真正有需要的人们。
Maybe 50 ringgit does not mean much to you.
50 ringgit 或许对你来说可能并不多。
But 50 ringgit might mean a tin of milk powder for a very needy mother to feed the baby.
那或许对一个很有需要的母亲来说，这个50 ringgit 能够帮助她买奶粉去喂养她的婴儿。
Or that 50 ringgit can buy enough of basic food to provide for a family.
或者可以买一些基本的那个食物去供应给一个家庭了。
So let us get God's wisdom in deciding how to be generous with our gold.
所以让我们真的是获得上帝的智慧，来懂得去如何的管理我们的金钱。
Have a look around your neighborhood.
所以我们也来看看一下我们的周围的区域。
At this time, for example, there are a lot of construction sites with foreign workers. They have no job, they have no money,And sometimes their families are with them, and they are really going through hard times.
所以在我们身边有可能有一些、外国的工人，他们在这个建筑工地里面，他们没有工作，没有工资，也没有食物能够养家糊口。
Is it possible that when you go shopping for yourself, you also buy for them, and then on the way home, you just drop by to bless somebody?
那我们是否有可能，当我们去购物的时候，我们也多买了一些的食物，然后我们在回家的路程上，我们也把这些的、食物去祝福这些的人。
So we need God's wisdom.
所以我们需要上帝的智慧。
Especially if we want to be generous with our gold.
特别是如果我们要很慷慨的来处理我们的金。
We also need to be generous with our words.
我们也同样的要用、要很慷慨的使用我们的言语。
Our words can either be gold or it can be rubbish.
我们的话语有可能成为金，也可能成为垃圾。
Our words can encourage and build people up in their faith, or it can be very negative and make people feel depressed.
我们的话语或许能够让人家在他们的信仰上被建立起来，也或许能够消极的让一个人完全的陷下去。
So before we post anything on Facebook,
所以当我们还没有、放任何的、这些评论在面子书上的时候，
Let us、be very wise in how we think.
让我们真的是在思想上成为那有智慧的人。
The word think means、ask ourselves the question, is it true?
所以我们说话之前或者播一些的东西之前，我们先想一下是否是真的。
Before we write it down,
那我们还没有写下来之前，
Is it helpful?
他真的能够帮助到别人吗？
Is it inspiring?
能够激励到别人吗？
Is it necessary?
有需要吗？
And is it kind?
那他是良善的话语吗？
If the answer is yes to all those five questions, then by all means, post something that can bless somebody.
如果那个答案对这个五个题目都是是的话，那尽量的就去写下这个评论评语。
So this is all about wisdom.
所以这个就是关乎到我们的智慧。
It's about how to be generous with our gold.
他也教导我们如何的慷慨的使用我们的金。
And we all will become more generous with our gold when we recognize that, number three, that we are all made in God's image.
那他能够帮助我们更加的慷慨对于我们的金，特别是在第三点，当我们认得上帝的形象。
You see, when you look at the Roman coin,
那当你在看这个罗马的这个、钱时候，
It has the image of Caesar.
它的这个银币上有该撒的形象。
Caesar might be the ruler of the Roman Empire.
那这个该撒呢，是这个罗马帝国的这个、管理的人。
But we must not forget that Caesar is like you and me. We are all created in the image of God.
但是我们不要忘记说，该撒跟你和我也一样，我们是按照上帝的形象而被造的。
So what does that mean for us?
所以这个意味着什么呢？
It means that we recognize that every human being is created in the image of God.
他告诉我们的是说，每个人呢都是按照上帝的形象而被造的。
We don't just help those who are Christians.
我们不只是帮助那些信徒们罢了。
But we help people of different race and religion from different situations in life.Because we see that they are created in God's image.
但是我们也帮助那些不同种族、不同肤色的人，因为我们认得说他们也是按照上帝的形象而被造的。
And when we help those in need, we honor God.
所以当我们帮助这些有需要的人的时候，我们其实是在荣耀神。
Proverbs 19 verse 17 says, Whoever is kind to the poor lends to the Lord, and he will reward them for what they have done.
那箴言书十九章十七节告诉我们说，怜悯贫穷的，就是借给耶和华，他的善行，耶和华必偿还。
This is God's invitation for all of us.
所以这个是上帝的邀约给每个人。
And the Bible promises that you will be rewarded for being kind to the poor.
那圣经也告诉我们说，当我们有这样的善行的时候，耶和华也必偿还我们每个人。
Why don't we try out the word of God?
那好吧，我们也试试一下上帝所给我们的这应许。
Proverbs 14 verse 21 says, It is a sin to despise one's neighbor, but blessed is the one who is kind to the needy.
那箴言书十四章二十一节告诉我们说，藐视邻居的这人有罪，怜悯贫穷的这人有福。
So look around your neighborhood.
所以好不好，我们观看一下我们的区域。
Are there people in need?
是否有需要的人呢？
Now, Proverbs 14 verse 31 says, whoever is kind to the needy honors God.
箴言书十四章三十一节却告诉我们说，怜悯穷乏的乃是尊敬主。
And we honor God honoring the image of God in every human being.
所以我们尊敬主呢，是能够透过当我们尊敬上帝的形象在每一个人类上。
What can we do in this time of MCO?
所以在这个行动管制令期间，我们能够做什么呢？
How can we be generous?
我们要如何成为那慷慨的人呢？
What can we do practically?
还是我们能够实际的做什么呢？
For example, we can offer skills training online if you are an expert in some skills.
那或许你在一些的技能上你是很专业的，那你可以提供在线的这个技能培训。
For children studying at home, online every day, give your teachers your full attention when you're online.
那给予孩子们呢，你应该给你线上的这个老师什么是属于他们的。
Give to your teacher what belongs to your teacher.
所以给你的老师属于他的。
And children, as you are at home, help out at home.
同样的，孩子们，你们在家的时候也可以帮忙做一些的家务。
Maybe you can learn new skills in cooking and other things.
或许你可以在烹饪当中学习一些新的技巧呢。
We can also donate our blood to the blood bank.
我们也可以将我们的血捐给那个血库。
Right now, for example, the Sarawak General Hospital is appealing for blood donors to donate.
所以好比现在我们的中央医院在请求这些捐血的人踊跃的去捐。
Perhaps it is the same wherever you are.
那无论你现在在哪里，那或许也是一样的状况。
Perhaps you can make that difference.
或许你可以做出改变。
We can also donate PPE to our local government hospital if they have need.
如果我们也可以捐那个防护装备给我们的医院。
In fact, our church has donated PPE to our local hospital.
那其实我们的教会呢，也捐赠了这个防护装备给我们的中央医院。
And if you want to take part in it, please contact us.
如果你要参与在其中的话，你也可以联系我们。
We can also find out whether there are needy people staying around our neighborhood.
我们也可以查明一下，在我们的这个住宅区是否有需要的家庭呢？
And maybe you're a landlord, perhaps you can consider lowering your rent for the tenants at this time because you want to be generous.
那如果你是一个房东的话，你也可以考虑在这个时候减少你的租金为了要表示你的慷慨。
Let me finish by reading Proverbs 11 verse 24 and 25.
然后在最后的时候，我为大家阅读这个箴言书十一章二十四到二十五节。
This is the truth that God wants us to get.
这个是上帝要我们领受的真理。
One person gives freely, yet gains even more. Another withholds unduly, but comes to poverty. A generous person will prosper. Whoever refreshes others will be refreshed.
有施洒的却更增添，有吝惜过度的反致穷乏，好施舍的必得丰裕，滋润人的必得滋润。
Our God desires us to be generous in our giving.
所以上帝希望我们每一个人都是慷慨的给予。
Our God desires us to trust Him through His Word.
我们的上帝也期望我们每一个人能够信靠他，透过他的话语。
There's one last thing I want to share as we close.
当我们在结尾的这个时候，我还要分享一样事情。
That God also has a coin.
那上帝也有这个硬币。
God has a currency.
上帝有这个货币。
And on God's coin, you're going to see the face of Jesus.
那在上帝的这个硬币上，你会看到耶稣基督的像。
And you will see the title of Jesus.
你也会看到耶稣基督的这个题字。
King of Kings, Lord of Lords.
万王之王，万主之主
，Savior of the world，
世界的救世主。
And you know, for everyone watching, when we pray in the name of Jesus, In other words, we use God's currency.
那我们每一个人在观看的这个时候，我要提醒大家，当我们祷告，我们是奉耶稣基督的名祷告，就是说我们看到上帝的货币就是耶稣的名字。
God wants to be generous to you also.
上帝也要对你是慷慨的。
Some of you are going to marriage problems right now.
或许有些人现在正在经历婚姻上的问题。
Call on the name of Jesus.
你呼求耶稣的名字。
Ask him to help you and your spouse.
呼求耶稣来帮助你和你的配偶。
Some of us find it hard to handle our children at home. Call on the name of Jesus.
如果你觉得你在家不懂怎么管理孩子的问题的话，你也可以呼求耶稣的名字。
Get God's wisdom.
获得他的智慧。
And so, friends, right now I want to pray for many of you who do not know Jesus Christ personally in your life yet.
那朋友们，这个时候我要特意的为那些还不认识耶稣基督的人来祷告。
God wants to be generous to you.
因为上帝对你也要慷慨。
Because he loves you.
因为他爱你。
If you're ready, join me to pray right now.
如果你预备好的话，你可以跟我一起做这样的祷告。
Lord Jesus, I admit that I am a sinner.
主耶稣，我承认我是一个罪人。
I believe that Jesus Christ died for my sins.
我相信耶稣为我的罪而死。
I pray right now that Jesus will come into my life.
我祷告耶稣，你这个时候进入我的生命。
And be my Lord and Savior.
成为我的主和救主。
In Jesus' name, Amen.
奉耶稣的名 ，Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Congratulations if I made that prayer.
恭喜你，如果你刚刚跟我做了这个祷告。
Please contact us so that we can help you in your journey.
那请你联系我们，好让我们能够帮助你在这个旅程上。
And for all of us today, let us be not just the hearers, but let us be the doers of God's word.
那给其他的弟兄姐妹们呢，让我们成为不止听到的人，也是行道的人。
It's time to be generous with our gold.
是时候让我们真的是慷慨地对待我们的金。
God bless you.
上帝赐福于你。
And before you go,please stay and watch an amazing story of how one person was generous with his gold.
那你还没有离开之前呢，请你留下来观看我们接下来这个见证，让我们看到一个人他如何的慷慨对于他的金。
God loves you, God bless you, and see you online next week.
上帝爱你，上帝赐福于你，我们下个星期再见。
拜拜。
拜拜。
Good morning, Pastor, brother, sister, and friends in Christ. I'm very thankful to the Lord for using me and Hopeless as a blessing to the community during this tough period of time. Starting 7 March 2020, a day before MCO was announced, I purchased and delivered the different PPE parts like personal protective equipment sponsored by Hopeless and sent to Sarawak General Hospital.I'm also deliver meals sponsored by member of public to the front lines. I was very excited that I could be of help. I did not fear going to the hospital because I knew God was with me. A part of this, I also deliver items sponsored by the Federal Chinese Association to SGH. As a result, my trip to SGH amount up to 5 to 6 times in a day. There was a time when I needto see the coronavirus dead body pass in front of me. I hope that I can do more for them because I feel very sad. Recently, I have delivered food and daily necessity to some family who were quarantined at home and desperate need food. When I deliver the food to them, they ask me how much. I say it's free. They can't believe it is free. The tear in their eyes I can see and smile spread across their face when I give them the supply.This makes me feel released and happy. I'm so blessed to be called by God to have an opportunity to serve and support the frontline and COVID-19 patients. The Lord said it is more blessed to give than to receive in the book of Acts 20:35. Thank you very much.